Hello guys, thanks for picking my video. I'm Neha Sheikh and this is my first ever video lecture. Hope it will help you. So let's get started. In this video, we are going to discuss about Microsporum, a pathogenic fungi. Microsporum comes under dermatophytes. Microsporum is the genus of fungi that comes under dermatophytes actually. Dermatophyte is a group of three types of fungus. Mainly Microsporum, Trichophyton and Dermatophyton. So in this lecture, we are going to discuss about Microsporum. It causes skin diseases in humans and animals. Microsporum fungi infects only keratinized tissue. It is the specialty of this Microsporum fungus that it infects only keratinized tissues like skin, hair and nails. They are restricted to only non-viable skin because they are unable to grow at 37 degrees Celsius. Some enzymes which help the fungi are called as a proteases, elastases, keratinases. These are the degradative enzymes which degrade keratinized tissues and serves as nutrients for them. Then the natural habitat of some Microsporum fungi is those who live in soil are called as geophilic. Those who affect animals are called as zoophilic, and those who infect humans are called as anthropophilic. So the infection caused by Microsporum are known as a ringworm infection or tinea. We can say tinea also. This is the very common disease which are very common in the human being. Here the infection is not caused by any worm, but it appears, the infected area appears like a ring on the skin, hence named as ringworm infection. Then next come to the morphological characteristic. Microsporum can be identified by their colonial appearance and microscopic morphology. After the growth of 2 weeks at 25 degrees Celsius and Suberout's dextrose agar, also called as SDA. Suberout's dextrose agar is the selective media for the growth of fungi. Microsporum species tend to produce distinctive multicellular microconidia and accumulated walls. Microsporum forms both macroconidia and microconidia on short conidiospores, i.e. hyphae. So the microconidia are large asexual reproductive structure, whereas microconidia are small asexual reproductive structure. Here you can see in the picture, the macroconidia are highly in multiseptate, 2 to 15 celled. And the microconidia are highly in single septate. Then the macroconidia are spindle shaped, or we can say it is a pencil shaped in some cases. Then the microconidia are small club shaped. This can be seen by the picture. Then the macroconidia are rough and thick walled, whereas the microconidia are smooth and thin walled. Macroconidia are 8 to 15 to 40 to 150 micrometer. Then the microconidia are 2 to 3 micrometer long. And depending upon the different types of species, we are going to differentiate them according to the morphological characteristic. So first is the Microsporum canis. So here the colonies are white cottony surfaced in deep yellow, color on reverse, thick walled. On this rice grains, a deep yellow pigment is produced by amkinase, which helps to differentiate it from other species like Microsporum odoni. Macroconidia here are abundant and thick-walled with many septate up to 15. Macroconidia are often hooked or curved at ends. We can see this in the picture. Then the microconidia here are small and club-shaped. Here you can see the small microconidias. Then here the in vitro hair perforation test is conducted to check whether the organism create perforated holes or on keratinized hair or not. So the Microsporum canis give positive result, and the Microsporum canis causes tinea capitis, tinea corporis, tinea barba, tinea manum. These all are the diseases of a ringworm infection, which we'll discuss about later. The next is the Microsporum odoni. Here the colonies are dense fur-like mat having radiating edges, grayish white to salmon pink colored colonies. Pectinate hyphae are present and rare macro and microconidia. It is anthropophilic, which means it infects animals as well as human. Hair and skin infected with amadoni gives fluorescence under Wood's UV light. Wood's UV illuminator is the diagnostic device. Then in vitro hair perforation test is negative hair. It causes tinea capatis and tinea corporis. Then the next species is Microsporum gypsum. Colonies hair forms a tan powdery colony. Reverse colony often appear rashed around edges. Macroconidia usually have 4 to 6 cells, whereas microconidia are smaller than amkenes. Geophilic as well as zoophilic. It mainly present on fur of rodents. It causes tinea capatis and tinea manum. Here you can see in the picture, Microsporum gypsum, the macroconidia are cucumber shaped, whereas the microconidia are pear shaped. Then next, Microsporum ferruginum. Colonies here are slow growing, flat, globrous, wrinkled, leathery to downy. Pale yellow colonies on Lowenstein Jensen medium differentiate it from others. Septate hypha usually deform and no macroconidia and microconidia are present, as you can see in this picture. Here in vitro hair perforation test is negative. It causes tinea capatis. The next is pathogenesis. Then here we will discuss about the disease, which is ringworm infection, different types of ringworm infections. So the first is tinea capatis. It is the ringworm of the scalp and hair. If the infection is in the hair or scalp, we can say it is tinea capatis. Firstly, the hypha invade the skin of scalp, then spread to the keratinized wall of the hair follicle. Here, hypha grow downward on the non-living portion of the hair. As the hair grows upward, the hypha produce chain of spores that forms a sheath around hair shaft. The infection produce dull, gray, itchy patches, which is so deadly. Then next disease is tinea corporis. Tinea corporis is the ringworm infection of the body. If the patches are here, if the patches can be seen on the body, it is called tinea corporis, which is very common in humans. Fungal metabolites, enzyme, antigens diffuse through the viable layer of epidermis. Here, vesicle form, then lesion expand in centrifugally and active hyphal growth at periphery. Here you can see in the pictures. Then next, tinea manum. It is the ringworm infection of the hand. It shows red, itchy, rash, burning, cracking and scaling. May be transmitted sexually or via scratching and touching. It typically start as a small patch, then gradually become larger. Then our next disease is tinea barba. It is the ringworm of the beard in moustache. Here you can see in the picture, which is so messy and ugly. It is same as tinea capatis. In tinea capatis, there is the ringworm infection of the skin. Here also the skin, but the portion of the body is different, which is the moustache and beard. Here the infection occurs as a follicular inflammation, mostly caused by trichophytons, rarely caused by Microsporum species. So that's all about the disease. Here, depending upon the species, the natural reservoir and ringworm infections are given. The first is Microsporum odoni, which is anthropophilic. It causes tinea corporis and tinea capatis. Microsporum canis is the zoophilic, which causes tinea corporis, tinea capatis, tinea manum and tinea barba. Then Microsporum ferruginum is the anthropophilic, which causes tinea capatis. Then Microsporum gypsum is the geophilic, also isolated from furs of rodents. It causes tinea corporis and tinea capatis. Apart from this, there are many more species of Microsporum, but these four species are the main, which causes tinea capatis, tinea corporis, tinea manum and tinea barba, which is the main infection type of ringworm infection. Then our next topic is laboratory diagnosis of Microsporum species. First, we can be diagnosed by nail clippings, skin scraping, hair placed in the slide, then 10-20% KOH is added with lactophenol blue stain, which is the stain to for staining of hypha and other macro and microconidias, and which is examined the sample then microscope to the determine presence of hypha. Then second diagnosis is Wood's lamp examination. It may be used to diagnose microsporum species that flourish, which is Microsporum odoni. Here you can see in the pictures. Then simply fungal culture can be used, medium can be used for positive identification of the species, which is Saberhaus dextrose agar. Then in vitro hair perforation test can be conducted, in which organism is placed in a petri dish with a water, yeast extract and a hair sample, and it can be performed. Here you can see the M-canis give positive result of hair perforation test, whereas M-odoni gives negative test. Next is the treatment of microsporum species ringworm infections. Here general antifungal medication can be used to treat microsporum ringworm infections. There are some topical medication and some oral medications. These all are the derivatives of fluconazole. Fluconazole is the antifungal medication widely used, in which topical medication is clotrimazole can be used, miconazole, econazole and terbinafine can be used. Then some oral medications are ketoconazole, griseofulvin, terbinafines and itraconazole can be used. These all are the fluconazoles which rupture the cell wall of fungi and gradually diffused it. This can be very useful against ringworm infections. I just want to tell you something here. I'm also a student and I have experienced about messy struggle for notes. So I want to share my own notes with my viewers. If you want it, click on the below link. Do like if understand and subscribe if you want to watch my upcoming videos. It gives me immense pleasure. Thank you all.